Naturopath, thanks for coming back. We're still talking about different types of omegas. The question is omega 3 and omega 7. What are the differences? Well, omega 3 are essential for health. In fact, if we look at all the different types of omegas out there, the omega 3s are some of the most important ones for us to include in our diet because our body doesn't make them. That means they're essential. Omega 7, like omega 9, is not, and like omega 6, they're not really essential, but it's good to have these omega 7s in your diet nevertheless. You know, there are two main types of omega 7s. We've got the palmitoleic acid and the vaccic acid, V-A-C-C, vaccinic acid, sounds like vaccine, vaccinic acid and palmitoleic acid. You'll find these particularly in avocado, but also sea buckthorn berries have got a lot of them in there. There are various plants that contain omega-7. Omega-7 showing some promise, again, as an anti-inflammatory, like a lot of omegas are showing. Macadamia nuts I've got here, oily fish. You'll find it in a whole lot of different types of foods. But I think avocados and macadamia nuts are about the highest sources. So this is also the omega-7s linked with lowering the bad cholesterol and increasing the good cholesterol. Look, it's the same with any fats. Avocado is just a king of fats. Avocado oil contains so many different ingredients in it that are so good for your health. People who eat avocados on a daily basis tend to have a lot less problems with their gut and their immune system than people who don't. And I'm sure it's because of these kind of omega fats in these avocados. The thing I like most about avocados, the satiety. When you've had a good feed of avocados, you feel like you've had a good feed. So there you have it. Omega-3 is essential, omega-7 is not essential, but still omega-7s are good to have in your diet to a degree. Thanks for tuning in.